cranberries. I like the relish. So on top of the venison, other meats, a lot of fish and shellfish, because those were the staples of the Pilgrim's diet. So if you want to wolf down a lobster or some oysters in lieu of turkey on Thursday, nobody can fault you for being inaccurate, because you would be right on the money. And of course, pumpkin pie didn't cap things off. It's a flagship dessert at the modern Thanksgiving dinner, but pumpkin pie didn't make an appearance at the first Thanksgiving. They lacked the butter and flour needed to make a pie, never mind the oven and everything. So it's not clear that they even had an oven, which, there you go. That doesn't mean pumpkins weren't available. They were probably served after being baked in the coals of a fire or stewed. Probably, I would think, like a squash. Laura, you're so funny. So they were I would imagine they were baked or in the coals or something, like a squash would be, or stewed. Pumpkin pie didn't become popular until the 17th century on American tables. And it might have shown up for Thanksgiving as early as the 1623 celebration, but I doubt it. It's just interesting facts. Interesting. And here's one for you. In a survey conducted by the National Turkey Federation, and who knew? Who knew we had this? The National Turkey Federation. I am amazed. I am really amazed that nearly 88% of Americans said they would eat turkey at Thanksgiving. The average weight of a turkey purchased for Thanksgiving is 15 pounds, which means some 690 million pounds of turkey. Wow, that's a lot of turkey. Who is the National Turkey Federation? Who knew we had this? Seriously, people? We're paying people for this? The National Turkey Federation. You gotta love it. You gotta love it. I just have to laugh at the National Turkey Federation. Who knew? Who knew? I love it. I love it. The National Turkey Federation. Help me out. What do you need, honey? Oh, yeah. She probably didn't understand what you were talking about, Valerie, because you're kind of vague sometimes, and all of a sudden you'll pop up with something, and, you know, if she wasn't, you know, there at the time. Yuck. Wow. So, there you go. The National Turkey Federation. Who knew we had that? I hadn't a clue to that. In 2001, the U.S. Postal Service issued commemorative Thanksgiving stamp. There you go. Designed by artist Margaret Cusack in a style resembling traditional folk art needlework. It depicted a cornucopia overflowing with fruits and vegetables under the phrase, "We give thanks." Oh, isn't that nice? Do you know what state? Who understands you? I don't know if I understand anybody. I just go with it. Honestly, I just go with it. You know what state is this, the top turkey producing state in America? You'll never guess. Do you have any clue, guys? Minnesota is the top turkey producing state in America, with a planned production total of 46.5 million turkeys. Six states, Minnesota, North Carolina, Arkansas, Missouri, Virginia, and Indiana, account for nearly two-thirds of the, get this, 240, I don't get you sometimes. No, I don't get me sometimes. So, there you go. Okay. No. Not always. I don't even understand me. So, there you go. Now, get this. That's two-thirds. Guess how many turkeys that will be raised in the U.S. this year? 248 million turkeys. That's a lot of turkey. Wow. The National Turkey Federation. Go figure. Did you ever think there was such a thing? Honestly, I didn't find out until I was doing research on that. It's the National Turkey Federation. Sounds like a Star Trek thing, don't it? In a survey conducted by the National Turkey Federation, nearly 88% of Americans said they would be having turkey this Thanksgiving. That is a lot of turkey, people. Poor turkeys. What did they ever do to somebody? You know, eat ham. Eat pork, the other white meat. Do something. Poor turkeys. Cranberry production in the U.S. is expected to reach 750 million pounds. Pounds, people. And, of course, Wisconsin, Massachusetts. Now, this I don't get. You got two western states, two eastern. Wisconsin, Massachusetts, New Jersey, Oregon, and Washington are the top cranberry-growing states. Now, go figure. It's like on opposite ends of the country. That's crazy. The major pumpkin-growing states are Illinois, California, Pennsylvania, and New York. Go figure. Who would figure New York for that? Or California, for that matter. They're the major pumpkin-growing states. Total U.S. production was over 1.5 billion. Billion, mind you, pounds. That's crazy. Crazy, crazy. Yeah, I never would have thought that with... the cranberries. It's like on two different coasts. That's so weird. I would have never thought of that. And of course, the sweet potato is most plentifully produced in North Carolina. It grew 972 million pounds of the side dish vegetable. That was in 2010. So you know it's gone up. California and Mississippi are also powerhouse potato states. Go figure. And the top producing states together generated over 2.4 billion pounds. And according to the Guinness Book of World Records, the largest pumpkin pie, now get this, I like to have a big fork to go with this. The largest pumpkin pie ever baked weighed 2,020 pounds. And it was 12 feet long. That's a pie, people. This was baked on October 8th, 2005, by the New Bremen Giant Pumpkin Growers in Ohio. Woo-hoo! Ohio, you go. New Bremen Giant Pumpkin Growers in Ohio. It included 900 pounds of pumpkin, 62 gallons of evaporated milk, 155 dozen eggs, imagine cracking those open, 300 pounds of sugar, 3.5 pounds of salt, 7 pounds of cinnamon, 2 pounds of pumpkin spice, and 250 pounds of crust. Now that's my kind of pie. That's my kind of pie. Absolutely. I know, isn't this cool? The National Turkey Federation sounds like something out of Star Trek, don't it? I love it. I love it, the name, the National Turkey Federation. I wonder if they have badges. Shape of turkeys. Wouldn't that be cool? I'm going to hell, I know it. I know it. Can you imagine the National... I'm from the National Turkey Federation. Here's my badge. Yes. I'd be like, are you kidding me? Can you imagine... I just can't even wrap my mind around that one. There's some more interesting things about the... does everybody watch the Macy's Parade Thanksgiving? I know, you and me both, Lori. What about whipped cream? They didn't say anything about whipped cream. Come on, you got to have whipped cream for pumpkin pie, right? Exactly, that's what I just said. Where's the whipped cream? Can you imagine how much whipped cream they would have used for that? Whoo! Yeah, buddy. You and me both, Lori. Dive right in that. Wow. What would you do if somebody came to your door and said they were from the National Turkey Federation? I'd probably just die laughing. I'd be like, yeah, really? No. Does everybody watch the parade on Thanksgiving? Macy's parade, of course. Who doesn't? Everybody, do you guys watch the parade on Thanksgiving Day? I mean, that's, you know, we see the man then. You know, Mr. Claus, of course. I'm going to take a small break, and we're going to be back with some more Thanksgiving tidbits. I have a recipe or two for you. Yeah, can you imagine? You're like, yeah, I'm from the National Turkey Federation. Yeah, go away. I just find that hilarious. That's just great. So what I want to know, what do you serve for Thanksgiving? What is your menu for Thanksgiving dinner? You think on that, and we'll be right back after a few songs.